Hi guys. Hello. So sorry, I'm a minute late. So today, just funny thing, my Zoom stopped working, and yesterday I did today everything that I did yesterday to that Zoom, and for some reason it was like not loading and not loading, and I'm like, oh well, that's okay, maybe it's just a sign that I need to just go live my regular ways without the Zoom. So I like using Zoom when I have a slides to share and things like that. So fortunately today there was no slides, so it's just me. I hope you guys excited about me, just seeing me, and so and that is okay, you know, that is okay. So yay, so today's day two of the challenge, save time and find balance. I am so excited, guys. I'm really, really excited. So today's topic of the challenge is balance possible? Is balance possible? So we're gonna talk more and in depth for that with you. And I am so sorry about my voice, guys. I don't know what's going on with me. I've been feeling like I can talk and it's fine. And you know, I had a little bit of the cold this past weekend, and I'm feeling better, but this voice just won't leave me. I have like a little bit of a raspy voice, so that's not my regular voice, guys. I promise you. So, and I don't know what's going on. But anyways, I am so excited to be here today. If you are here with me today watching live, please put hashtag live. And if you're watching here with me, if you're watching here with me in the replay, please put the hashtag replay. I would like to hear from you. Please put hashtag live. Please put hashtag replay, whether you're live and replay. I will definitely give you a shout out. And if you do have any questions, also don't hesitate to put them in there. I always so excited to hear from you guys, and I always give you a shout out during my lives, and I will answer all your questions if you have any as well. So why am I asking you to do this? Because there will be prizes at the end of the challenge that are given for the participation. And if you do participate, and if you put hashtag live, or if you put hashtag replay, then you can win prizes. And I am so excited about that. I'm so excited to share the prizes with you. So if you're new to my world, I'm Jenny Black, and I am a coach. I help high achieving women to grow in self-love, positive self-talk, and mindset shifts for more peace, balance, and happiness. That's what happens when you have a raspy voice, guys. So I am passionate about what I do because I was one chasing the peace, balance, and happiness just to never find them. For so long, I chased them without any success. So balance was definitely something that I struggled personally with for the very long time, as I believed there should be a magic formula, something that others knew that I didn't. And I was like, why, like everyone talks about this work-life balance and they seem to be you know, just nailing it, and I'm missing something. So until I realized it was all in my head. No one really nails it on the head. No one really knows it all. And I had to address it in one way or another. So fast forward to today, I went through amazing transformation, complete change of my life. Now I enjoy my life. I feel at ease. I feel happy, other than my raspy voice, guys. I feel happy and satisfied more than I ever been before. So my life is so different and so much better than it used to be. That is why I'm so passionate about sharing what I learned with you and sharing everything that worked for me and for others, so you can transform your lives too and find that more peace, that balance, and that happiness in your life as well. So, guys, if you're just joining me, please don't forget to put hashtag live or hashtag replay. I would love to see you there. I would love to see those hashtags. There will be prizes for participating, and that is why I'm asking you to do that. So, if you're watching it in the replay as well, don't forget to put hashtag replay. I would really love to see that. Okay. So let's talk a little bit about what are the prizes, what can you win. So I have two awesome prizes, guys. So prize number one, it's 1 hour free strategy session with me that will help you to lessen your stress and anxiety and amp up your peace, balance, and happiness. We can spend that 1 hour with you on whatever you believe would be the best. In the best way that will serve you. So I will be at your disposal for disposal for 1 hour. This voice, guys, is like killing me today. Sorry. I seem to not be able to pronounce things. So anyway, so it's 1 hour free strategy session with me. It could be your prize. Oh, another awesome prize that I have is $100 credit that can be applied to any coaching session with me, whatever you choose. So you really want to put that hashtag live or hashtag replay in order to be able to participate in that. Hey Kim, thank you so much for saying hi. So how can you win the prizes? Well, you can win the prizes if you participate, if you watch all the challenges, if you comment hashtag live, if you comment hashtag replay, if you do your homework. So the person who participates the most and brings the best of their energy to this challenge is gonna win those prizes. Actually, two people, because we have two prizes, right? So yes, so please, please, guys, please leave your hashtags, hashtag live, hashtag replay, and also please do your homework. Awesome, Kim, thanks for your hashtag. So glad you can join me live today. If you can join, if you're here with me, and if you're watching in replay, I'm so happy that you also found time to watch it. So let's go back to the challenge. So this is day two of the challenge, save time and find balance. So yesterday we talked about how we can become more effective in handling our tasks. We covered how we can streamline our tasks, how we can prioritize them, how we can handle them in a better way. We also talk about so-called thorny tasks, or the tasks that bring you pain, or you also can call them the tasks that you like to procrastinate. Yes, and I know some of you already said that they're gonna work on those tasks, and I'm so excited for you. You guys are gonna feel so much better once they are done and out of your way. I know I always feel better when I get those tasks off my to-do list, and I'm like, it's like a huge, huge weight lifted off me, and I'm like, yay! So that is gonna really help you in so many ways. So if you want more information about it, it's still here in this group. So go back, watch it. Don't forget to put hashtag replay on it if you're watching it in replay. So, and then you will be entered to win the prizes. So during this challenge, we are discussing three topics. So day one was all about becoming more efficient. So today is we're going to be talking about how to balance your life better. And the day three is going to be about mindset. All three topics are my favorite. I love them, and I love sharing with you guys everything that I know. So once again, if you're watching it with me, don't forget to put hashtag live. If you're watching it in replay, put hashtag replay, and I cannot he wait to hear from you. So now let's jump right in into the topic of today. Is balance possible? So today we're talking about balance, and this is also one of my absolutely favorite topics because so many people wonder about that, and we hear so much about life a work balance, and sometimes we don't know how we can balance it, right? So sometimes we're like, well, seems like everyone is getting it, so how I am not getting it? That's how I used to be. That's how I used to think. So it seems like everyone is nailing that life work balance, and I'm not. So what can I do about it? So let's jump right in and let's talk a little bit about it. So guys, sorry, I'm gonna take a sip. I apologize once again for my raspy voice. I'm just coming off of the cold. Hey, Mary, thank you so much for watching. Hey, Maria, awesome. So glad to have you here with me. So balance is very elusive thing, because what balance for one person is not balance for another. And it was a hard thing for me to learn. So what if we want to be brutally honest with ourselves, how we want to see our lives in order to understand, so we really, really need to brutally, like, to amp up that honesty, look at our life and be honest with us to understand what balance means for us and what it means really to have our life balance. Because so many people talk about this balance, but that's why it feels so elusive, because what balance is good for one person is not good for another. And even at the different stages of your life, it could be absolutely different and look absolutely different. So, I'm gonna give you two examples from my own experience, where balance meant absolutely different things for me. So, first, I wanted to go a little bit back in time when I was a PhD student. So, yes, at one time I was a PhD student. I started a PhD program, which was in business, guys. At that time I was a recent expat. So like I came if you know, I immigrated here to the US from Russia, and so I was quite new to the US. So it was re really, really hard on me at that point, because I didn't all my family was left behind, and I didn't have tons of friends here. I was kind of new. I knew some people, but not a lot. And at that time, I was a PhD student, and I wasn't making also lots of money, because I was a teaching assistant at that time. And so the money that came was through that teaching assistant sponsorship that I was getting. So as you can imagine, wasn't a lot of money. So at that time, how did I feel? So what I remember that I struggled. I struggled because I felt I was out of balance. I felt I had too much of certain things and too little of other things. So I felt I was out of balance at that time. What did I want? Well, I wanted more money. I wanted more friends. I wanted potentially to have a family here, right? What did it mean for me? I didn't know at that time whether it meant to have my family come here or to create my own family. I just wanted to feel that I wanted to have more family. I also felt that at that time I had too much time on my hand. And if you ever been a PhD student, or you know a PhD student, you might know what that means. So like that's just the whole idea of the PhD program. So when you're in this program, you probably have more time than some other students, because you're given the time to do the research, to kind of explore into your field, to write a thesis, to work on something, right? But that time is quite unstructured, and you have to kind of put it together for yourself, and you have to structure it for yourself in a certain way. So I felt out of balance. Honestly, I felt I was out of balance because I felt like I had too much time on my hand and not enough money. So at that time, my needs were absolutely different than other times in my life. So now I'm going to give you a second example, also from my life. So, but that was a little bit later in my life. So later in my life, I worked in the corporate America, and I was a young mother. I had a kid who was at that time under 3 years old. So she was young, and I was pregnant with my second child. So if you don't know, I have two kids actually, two daughters. So at that time, I was pregnant with my second, and I had a young child, and I was working in the corporate America. So that time, I also felt out of balance. I was constantly running everywhere, but I felt out of balance for different reasons. I wanted more freedom and more time to see my daughter and spend more time with her and with my new family, because I had a husband at that time and I wanted to spend more time with him, and I wanted to spend more time with my little girl, and I wanted to maybe even have more time to sleep because I was pregnant and I was constantly tired. So I still wanted to be invested in my career, but I wanted to have more time with the family. And at that time, I was more stable financially, where I would be willing to sacrifice some of that money to have more time with my daughter. So as you could see, it depends. It really balances. It depends on what we're going through. And for some people, at their point in their life, it could be that they're wishing for more time. And it's and for some people, it means maybe more money or anything else. Maybe you have some other wishes and desires. It's all so very personable. And also for me, as you could see, both of those examples were me, but at the different stages in my life. So we also go through the different stages of our lives. And during this time, balance means something different for us at every stage. Okay, so balance is really very personable, and we need to connect to our deep wishes and desires, to our soul, and to better understand what is that, what balance means for us. So if you guys willing, I am gonna share with you some questions right now that is gonna help you really to pinpoint what means the balance for you right here, right now, and what do you want more and on your deeper level at this point in your life. So if you have a pen and or a pencil and a little piece of paper, you can pull it up, and we're gonna go through those questions. It shouldn't take that long. So if you want to grab a pen or a pencil and grab a piece of paper, we're just about to jump into it. So if for some reason you cannot do it right now, so I'm going to have this recording still in this group for a little bit longer. So until the end of this week, this recording is going to be in this group, so you can always go back and go through those questions again. And I think I'm going to try to drop them up in comments as well after I do that with you, okay? So let's get to those questions. So let's come down. Let's take a deep breath, and we're going to go through those questions. So deep breath. And so let's start with the first questions. Do I feel like I have balance right now? Do I feel like I have a balance right now? So just write what comes into your mind first. You don't have to think about it hard. So usually what comes first is the best answer. So now to the next one. Where do I feel out of balance? So where do I feel out of balance? So write down again what comes up. Where do I feel out of balance? Okay. So number three, it's the third question. So let's go to the third questions. What do I wish I can have more of? What do I wish I can have more of? Again, just write down what comes up. What do I wish I can have more of? Don't need to think about it too much, just write down what comes up, okay? So the next question, am I willing to sacrifice anything that I have right now to get more of what I want? Am I willing to sacrifice anything that I have right now to get more of what I want? Again, just write it down, whatever comes up. I'm gonna repeat it one more time. Am I willing to sacrifice anything that I have right now to get more of what I want? And the final question, are my expectations realistic? What setup would I be happy with, and is it achievable? Are my expectations realistic? What setup would I be happy with, and is it achievable? All right, guys. So if you want to share anything, drop it in the comments. If you're just joining us, don't forget to put hashtag live or hashtag replay. We'd love to hear from you guys. So one more time, the last question, I'm repeating it. Are my expectations realistic? What setup would I be happy with, and is it achievable? All right. So how do you guys feel about going through those questions? So those questions are really, really gonna help you to kind of start nailing it. What balance means for you? What do you need to adjust in your life in order to feel more in balance? What do you want to see more of? What can you sacrifice in order to get it? Is that possible? What adjustments can be made? Right? So share your thoughts if you have anything. I would love to hear from you. And we're gonna move on to the next point for today's challenge. So we continue talking about the balance, and we talked about first we talked about that the balance is different for everyone, and what balance means for one person doesn't necessarily mean balance for another person. So now, based on the questions that we just answered, we want to take a hard look at our life and understand if what we want to see is in alignment with our current life. Can we make adjustments? What adjustments are needed? And sometimes adjustments can be big, and sometimes adjustments can be small. So based on those answers, you should be able to look at it and say, what adjustments do I need in my life to feel more in balance? And I'm gonna give you examples again from my life. So we're gonna go back to that example number one, where I was a PhD student. So what adjustments did I make in my life at that point of time? So at that time, I understood that I was not in alignment with what I wanted. It just started coming to me all of a sudden. I had all this time on my hand, and I had really not, I really didn't have the money that I wanted and friends, and I wasn't exposed to people that I wanted. So I understood something big had to happen. I started to understand that life of the PhD student was not something I wanted to continue. Moreover, I understood what PhD would lead me to, the life that I wasn't inspired to live. it would not be in alignment with what I wanted. So I made a huge adjustment. I quit PhD program and I became an MBA student. So I also understood that I got myself in that position because I let other people influence decision of my career. So I made a large adjustment to align with my own soul intent of what was aligning with me more at that period of time. And I started working part-time while doing my MBA, and it really addressed so many things for me because all of a sudden I become busier. I didn't have as much time on my hand. I started to have more money because I was working part-time. I started to be more became more exposed to more people, which allowed me to meet more friends and eventually also meet my future husband. So that was an adjustment for me for that first example. So, hey Kim, thank you so much for sharing. So you're saying that letting go of your career to pursue entrepreneurship full time. Yay, so excited for you. I'm so, so excited for you that you're jumping into entrepreneurship. I know it's always a hard jump, but we are cheering for you and this is an awesome, awesome transition. Thank you so much for sharing. So sometimes like that, Kim, we need to jump all in. We need to make those big, big adjustments in order to feel in balance and in order to honor what our soul is calling us to do. And sometimes those adjustments can be scary. I know, but if that's what you feel, if that's what you feel you're called to do, I feel, you know, you have to go for it. You have to go for it, girl. And we're here cheering on you. So now let's talk about the second example and what adjustments I made in my second case. So in my example where I was a young mother who worked in corporate and I had a little kid who was under 3 years old and I was also pregnant, what adjustments did I make in this situation? So at that time, I realized I didn't need to make the huge adjustments. I understood that I would have to find just more time somehow to spend with my daughter. And when I did have that time with my daughter, I would have to be more mindful of that time and more cherishing of that time. So the adjustments in this circumstance were not as huge as in the first time for me. So so what did this adjustment include? They included finding a housekeeper. So I didn't need to spend time on the weekend cleaning. So as I mentioned, at that time I was working in corporate. And so I was willing at that time sacrifice a little bit of money to gain that time. So the hiring a house cleaner is one of the examples that I decided to spend the money to gain the time with my daughter. I also became more present with her, cherishing time that we spent together. So when I had time to spend with her, I was trying to be more concentrated on her and not being distracted with other things. I also was trying to leave my work behind when I was getting home. So when I would like come back from the office, I would close the computer and I would try not get on it unless in the cases of extreme circumstances, which could always happen. So that's for sure. And so far we guys talked about the balance and the fact that the balance means for everyone is a different thing. We also talked about that sometimes in order to get this balance, we need to analyze our life and understand what adjustments have to be made. So the last thing that we're also going to talk about the balance today is building your plan for your adjustments. So once you understand what has to be done in order to get you closer to that balance, And once you kind of map out those adjustments, now it's the time to move to that and start bringing them to life. And those are usually the scariest, especially if you're making such a huge jump like Kim. And so those are the sometimes it can be scary, but if you plan it, it should everything work out, right? It should. Sometimes it doesn't, but we doing always our best. So so very often when we talk about the adjustments, in the majority of the cases, those are not huge adjustments. Very often it's the simple things that really count. So as I mentioned, in the case with my daughter, when my daughter was so little, it was cherishing the time that I have, meaning being fully present, not being on my phone when I'm around her, not thinking, oh my God, what is going on with my work? It's playing with her, it's dedicating time to her, doing things with her, taking her to playground, and being fully present at those moments. It's also becoming less resentful when we do activities that seem to unlevel us or take us out of the balance. So, in the case with my daughter in this example, I could have been very resentful towards my work and saying, hey, this work is taking away the time from me that I could be spending as a young mother with my daughter. And instead, I have to send her to the daycare. I can't see her as much. I could have been very resentful about it. But I understood that that was my choice. It was my choice to work because I wanted to continue my work. I wanted to continue in my career at that period of time. And moreover, me and my family also depended on the money that I was bringing in. So reminding myself all the time that this is my choice to work, and my choice to put this time towards this job also helped me not to become resentful towards the activities that I felt were taking me out of balance. Reminding ourselves that it's always our choice to do all things in our lives can help to lower our resentment in so many ways, and it also will keep us more in the balance. So, guys, we cover it today. Is balance possible? We talked about whether the balance is very personable for everyone, and what it means for one person doesn't mean the same for another person. We also went through the questions which is sometimes a hard question to ask ourselves, whether we in the balance and what can help us to get more in the balance and feel better. We also talked about how we can make adjustments to our lives to feel better and be more in the balance. And finally, we talk about that the right mindset around those adjustments is also everything. And sometimes when we cannot make big adjustments, all these small adjustments really count, and they might seem so simple, but believe me, they will make the huge difference on your life. So, don't leave yet. So, I have a little bit of a homework that will help you to move even deeper on this balance. So, if you are guys, once again, if you're watching it live, please, and you just joined us, please put hashtag live. If you're watching it in replay, please put hashtag replay. There will be prizes at the end of the challenge, which I will be announcing the winners on Saturday for people who participated the most. So, yes, so definitely put your hashtags, and I would love to share those prizes with you. So if you hear all of that, you feel like, oh, this is all great, but it's only like scratches a little bit of the surface of what is going on with my life. If you want more information, if you want more help, if you want to go deeper on any of those subjects that we're covering during this challenge, whether it's the balance that we talked about today or prioritizing your tasks and finding what's more important for you, what we talked about yesterday, or if it's a mindset that we will cover tomorrow, please know that I have one-on-one program that you can work with me in. It's called Rewired for Peace Transformational Program, and it is absolutely amazing and it's fully customizable. So whatever you want to spend more time on, I will be honored to spend more time on with you there. So in this program you will get one-on-one support with me, and as I said, it will be customized to fill your needs to the best level possible, so you can reach that balance, peace, happiness that you so crave. That program delivers results, and right now, during this week of the challenge, I'm putting it on a special. So if you sign up this week, you will get 1 month free, and this is the most amazing deal that I have run in a long, long time. So it's absolutely amazing. I'm not sure I'm gonna have it ever again, guys. So please, please, if you're interested, or even if you're thinking, oh, I'm kind of on the fence, reach out to me. I would love to jump with you on a discovery call. Discovery call is absolutely no pressure. So send me a message. I'll be honored to jump on with you on a discovery call and talk a little bit more about that. Hey Kimber, hey Kim, thank you as well. So thank you for participating. So now let's go to the homework. So the homework is really easy today. So if you already answered the questions above, that is awesome. So then your homework is to think about what adjustments you can do today to come closer to the life of balance that you desire. So it's that simple, okay? So if you still haven't answered the questions, I'm gonna be dropping them off in the comments right now. So give me a second, guys. I am actually dropping them off as we are talking. So if you haven't gone through those questions, this is your homework to go through the questions. And if you did answer the questions, then your homework is think about what adjustments you can make to your life in order to find balance today. So, and I'm dropping that in the comments as well. Yay, guys. So, if you do have any questions, don't hesitate to put them in the comments or send them to me in via Messenger. I always love hearing from you guys, whether it's in the comments or via Messenger. So, thank you once again for participating in this challenge. I'm so excited to help you to save time and find balance this week. One more time, don't forget to put your hashtags. Put hashtag live if you're watching it live. Put hashtag replay if you're watching it in replay for each video, so you are qualified to win the prizes. Thanks again for listening, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.